The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 3rd Chapter, text number 29, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 4th, 1972, in Los Angeles.
Whoever carefully recites the mysterious appearances of the Lord with devotion in the morning and in the evening gets relief from all miseries of life.
This is called Phalasruti, result. This chapter was describing different incarnations of God, and it is concluded that Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. There were many incarnations, and incarnations are coming incessantly, just like there are waves in the ocean or in the river. You cannot sit down and count how many waves are flowing. And it is not possible. Similarly, you cannot also count how many incarnations are there, how they are coming out. But the most important of them are described. And the conclusion is made that Krishna is the origin, as it is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Aham sarvasya prabhava. I am the origin of everything. Even the incarnation. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate. Everyone, all incarnations, all demigods, all living entities, all energies, the Vedanta Sutra also confirmed, janmadasya jataha. The absolute truth is that which is the original source of everything. So sometimes we mistake that Krishna is also incarnation. No, he is not incarnation. He is the source of incarnation. Therefore, in the last verse, it has been clearly, iti chaṃsa kala puṃsa Krishnastu Bhagavān Svayam. Krishnastu Bhagavān Svayam. They are from Krishna, not Krishna is from them. Sometimes they argue that Krishna is the incarnation of Vishnu, but that is not the fact. Vishnu is incarnation of Krishna. Now there is no use arguing, because there is no difference between incarnation and the source of incarnation. The example is given, just like dīpācire vahī dasāntaram abhupetya dīpāyate. Just like you have got 1,000 candles here. The first you light on one candle, then the second, the third, the fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, go on increasing. Each candle is equal to another candle. So far candle power light is concerned, there is no difference. The first candle and the second candle, although second candle is lit up from the first candle, but the power of light is the same, either in the first candle or in the second candle. Similarly, do not think that because Krishna is the original candle, and the next candle is Balaram or Ram, that does not mean Balaram or Ram is less powerful than Krishna. They are equally powerful. Dīpācire vahī dasāntaram abhveta dīpāyate nahi tata pṛthakasti. There is no difference. So don't consider that incarnation means less important. No. But because Krishna is the original source, therefore Bhagavata is pointing out that these incarnations, all these incarnations, they are expansion of the original personality of Godhead Krishna, or expansion of the expansion, kala, angsha and kala. Angsha means direct expansion, and kala means expansion of the expansion. Just like Krishna's direct expansion is Balaram. Then from Balaram there is further expansion, Sankarsan, Aniruddha, Pradyumna, like that. Then Mahavishnu, another expansion. Then from Mahavishnu to Garbhodak Sai Vishnu. Then Garbhodak Sai Vishnu to Kiradok Sai Vishnu. From Kiradok Sai Vishnu, Paramatma, Ishara, Ishara Sarvabhutanam, Riddhesi Arjuna Tishti, they all pervading. So, all of them are expansion and equally power. But still, for understanding, for pure knowledge, we should understand that Krishna is the origin. Aham Sarvasya Prabhu. This is it. So anyone will recite these incarnations of God, Krishna, regularly in the morning and evening, that is the Phalasruti, Janma Guhyam Bhagavato. Bhagavato, he is the original source of everything, and he is taking birth. Therefore it is called Guhyam. It is very mysterious. Just like Kunti, when offered prayer to Krishna, she said that you are inside and you are outside, you are all pervading, you are present everywhere, still people cannot see you. This is the mystery. God is everywhere, but we cannot see. How it is? That is explained by Kunti. Just like somebody's father is playing on the stage, dressed in a different way, like a king or something, but the son cannot recognize, although the father is playing just before him. The father is playing in his front, but he cannot understand. He is saying some king is playing. Similarly, God is everywhere. God is everywhere. Simply you require to purify your eyes to see God. Otherwise God is everywhere. It is not that God has to be searched out some long, long... Of course His real abode is long, long distance. But still, He is within your heart. Ishara sarvabhuti sarvabhutanam riddhesi arjuna tishtati. So, to purify the eyes, we require that is meditation.